Shalom, everyone. This week we're going to be reading Parshat Shlach, the painful Parsha of the Meraglim. We know that when the Meraglim, the spies, they came back and they gave their evil report to Bnei Yisrael, we know that the Jewish people at the time they cried. And Chazal tell us in Masechet Ta'anit Daf Kaf Tet that because we cried that night, Atem bachitem, b'chiya shel chinam, we cried a cry for no reason. Vani koveh lechem b'chiya ledorot, that Hashem is now establishing a crying for generations. That night, that was Tisha B'Av. And of course, we know all the tragedies throughout Jewish history that happened on Tisha B'Av. As well, in Eichan Perek Aleph, the Pasuk, b'chot tivkeh b'layla, it's a time of crying. However, the Menachem Tzion, Harav Menachem Bet Tzion Zaks, he points out that there are two types of tears. The first type of tears are negative tears, tears that have no point, tears that come from a place of giving up, of yeush, of being depressed, of being sad, of not having any hope. They're the type of tears that you cry when you have to do what you have to do anyways. You're just miserable doing it. So you cry, but it doesn't help. It doesn't do anything. However, there's a second type of tears. These are the positive tears, the tears that have an effect, the tears of rebuilding, the tears of Rachel Imenu. When Rachel Imenu cries, those are tears of rebuilding, of doing and accomplishing. Yes, we've had in our history the tears that are sad, the tears that are negative tears of all the suffering that we've incurred. But there are also the tears of rebuilding. In our generation, we have the unbelievable merit of having these second type of tears. Yes, they're tears, and it is hard, but the tears of rebuilding. Ultimately, the tears of rejoicing at having Medinat Yisrael, being back in Eretz Yisrael, that we should get to a place that there is no more tears of suffering, only tears of joy. Shabbat Shalom.